Here we have a hop bush, and all of these hop bush here are pruned into a geometric shape, which is obviously not very natural. What we also can tell is that there is repeated shearing of these hop bush, and what that means is that the leaves on this shrub over here that should be doing photosynthesis, the leaves that should be going throughout the canopy and further down into the canopy, they are severely compromised because they are repeatedly cut back. Whenever that happens, the plant has to send out new smaller shoots over here to cover the area, which obviously then is cut back again. Sometimes people do this to keep a plant to a smaller size, but what happens is over time people see these shrubs grow bigger and bigger because you have to keep cutting them back, always a little bit above the previous cut. What you can see here is that these shrubs have been cut repeatedly because of the many branches that we're seeing here. We also know from research that plants that are cut perpetually in this manner actually use more water than plants that are allowed to have a fuller canopy and that are allowed to grow naturally to their full potential. Now, this hop bush naturally would get to be about 6 to 8 feet tall. It can get up to 6 feet wide. So the question is, why would somebody have a very dense planting of these shrubs over here when they then have to cut that size down? So a possibility would be to maybe remove some of these shrubs, let them grow to their potential. Now, once a shrub is in this shape, something like hop bush can be completely renovated. It can be cut off to a height of about 6 inches above the ground, and it will then resprout. If left alone, this shrub can grow into a natural growth habit and does not require any shearing.